Hi, I'm Mick Roderick. I'm the Woodland and Birds Program Manager in New South Wales for BirdLife Australia. We're standing here this morning in the spotted gum ironbark forests of the Lower Hunter, very important region for woodland birds. We can hear some woodland birds flying around now because there's some spotted gum blossom. But one of the other really important habitat attributes of these forests are the mistletoe plants. Okay, so over here on this spotted gum tree, we've got what's called a long-flowered mistletoe, Dendroptera vitellina is the Latin name. It has a number of host trees. In these parts, spotted gum is the main host tree. So mistletoe is a parasitic species that thrives in the branches of other trees. It does not have its roots in the ground. It gets all its water and nutrients from its host tree. And it's actually a very important plant as habitat for a number of woodland birds. So when these mistletoes flower, we get a number of nectar feeding species taking the nectar, and also after the mistletoe flowers, it produces berries, and a number of native Australian birds feed on the berries of the mistletoe. But very importantly, this mistletoe provides nesting habitat for Regent Honeyeaters, a critically endangered bird that occurs in these Lower Hunter forests when it flowers, which is around November, December. So at the moment we can see that there's no blossom on the plant, but still that will provide habitat for insects. Just the structure of the mistletoe is very important as habitat. Things like possums will also eat the foliage of mistletoe. They're an amazing plant that provides habitat for a number of birds and animals in any forest environment. If we continue further down, we've actually got a second species of mistletoe. This is a box mistletoe, Amyema miquelii, and you can see that the host tree for this mistletoe is completely different, whereas the long flower mistletoe was in a spotted gum. This box mistletoe is growing in a broad-leaved ironbark. This box mistletoe, as the name implies, also grows in box trees such as white box and grey box, but here we have a nice example of one in an ironbark. And again, the mistletoe is not currently flowering or fruiting, but it still provides a structural habitat for insects, and mammals will eat the foliage as well. So mistletoes are a very important part of any functioning ecosystem. A lot of scientists believe that mistletoe is a keystone species. A keystone species meaning a keystone such as in an archway. When a keystone is removed, the archway collapses, and a keystone species in an environment is very important, and mistletoe is one of those keystone species. Many studies have been done to show that the incidence of mistletoe in a woodland environment greatly increases bird diversity. We can hear some noisy friarbirds, spotted pardalotes, lorikeets around us right now, and all of those birds will use mistletoe at some stage. So the mistletoes generally have a very tubular flower, so things like lorikeets don't get into the blossom so much because they haven't got a long beak, but honeyeaters such as spinebills and friarbirds are well and truly able to get in and get the nectar out of the mistletoe. And regent honeyeaters will quite readily take the nectar from mistletoe. So as this mistletoe provides habitat for a critically endangered bird, it becomes even more important in these woodlands. So in the Upper Hunter, we have three main species of mistletoes. And this one here is the box mistletoe. Box mistletoe occurs in white box, ironbarks and other trees in the Upper Hunter. The box mistletoe is the familiar mistletoe that we see in roadside trees and in paddocks. You see this one here has actually got a little bit of spent blossom on it. These mistletoes provide great habitat for birds. It's a reliable food source when it's flowering for nectar, and also when it's fruiting, birds eat the fruits, and mammals will also eat the foliage as well. And just the structure of the plant makes a really useful nesting site for birds. So it's a very important part of any environment. The other mistletoes that occur in the Upper Hunter are the grey mistletoe, and the grey mistletoe occurs in wattle trees much lower down. Its foliage is quite grey, glaucous coloured. It's a very important food source when it flowers for the painted honeyeater,
And of course the other mistletoe occurs in the river she-oaks, the needle-leaf mistletoe. And when it flowers, it not only provides habitat for painted honeyeaters as well, but it's a nesting site for the critically endangered regent honeyeaters. So overall, these mistletoes are an extremely important part of our upper Hunter forest. So mistletoes dispersed a bit differently to most plants. Almost exclusively, mistletoe is dispersed by birds and predominantly by mistletoe birds. And as the name suggests, mistletoe birds specialise in eating mistletoe. So they eat the fruit and then they pass the fruit very quickly. It only sits in the digestive system for about 20 minutes or so. And the mistletoe bird passes the fruit onto a branch, and then that's how the mistletoe is spread. In this instance, we've got a box mistletoe. It's quite low down, it's only maybe 2.5 metres from the ground. Generally speaking, mistletoe birds deposit the mistletoe fruit quite high up in the canopy. So you can see mistletoe in all parts of a tree, but sometimes you can see mistletoe this low down. Mistletoe can have a bit of a bad reputation in that it can be viewed as being responsible for the death of eucalypt trees. That can happen, but that's normally in a situation where the tree is already stressed. It normally happens in paddock trees, and those trees are senescing. It hasn't got the usual mechanisms to deal with the mistletoe that trees in a normal forest environment have. And so, in reality, mistletoe is just another plant as part of the ecosystem. It is not in the mistletoe's best interest to kill its host tree. So mistletoes do not seek to kill the trees that they live on.